Welcome back. Now in this video, we're going to be talking about the select area portion of your recording toolbar. And if you go to the drop down menu, you're going to notice a couple of sections. You're going to notice a section that says widescreen, standard, and recent areas. Now widescreen and standard represent the aspect ratio. And in most cases, video that is done and posted to YouTube and other common forms of video sharing, they're going to have a widescreen aspect of 16:9. That would mean that you're either going to shoot in the highest resolution at 1080 or 720 or 480. But you want to make sure that you're matching the widescreen aspect of your screen. You can also shoot in a standard aspect. And again, this really depends on your screen. You can either shoot in a higher resolution or a lower resolution. You are now looking at PowerPoint. And one of the things that you'll notice if you go to the design section of your PowerPoint and you go to the slide size, you will notice that you can either choose the standard aspect or you can choose the widescreen aspect. And again, this is how you will want to match your PowerPoint presentation with your actual video or your actual screen. Now, when you use the wrong aspect ratio, what can happen is that your video can appear stretched or out of proportion. So when you are watching a video that has been recorded in the 4:3 aspect ratio, but you're watching it on the widescreen, it can either be stretched or it can have the sides cut off or truncated. So again, you want to make sure that you're going to record in widescreen when possible. And if not, if you're going to use the aspect ratio of 4:3, you want to record in as high a resolution as possible. But in many cases, the most common format is going to be that you'll want to use the 1080 or 720 aspect ratio within 16:9. Once again, one thing that Camtasia will allow us to do is to lock to a particular application. And in this particular case, we can lock to the calculator if we want to record just the calculator. If we want to make sure that we're not locked to an application and we want to select the area, we can just push the custom button. We push the custom button, and as we have discovered, and as we have discussed in a previous video, we can move this screen around to determine where we're going to actually record. And if we're just going to work with the full screen, we can do that by clicking the full screen button. The one last thing that you'll notice about the recording toolbar is going to be particularly helpful if you use two monitors or three monitors or multiple monitors. Recording toolbar can be moved to one of your other screens. So if you wanted to focus on recording the screen that you're looking, you can actually do that, and you can actually remove this recording toolbar any place that you actually want by just clicking your mouse and moving it where you want it to be. Okay, so with that, thanks, and I will see you in another video.